Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Thank you so much for coming here and braving the rain. With me on stage today are the New York State Department of Labor Deputy Commissioner for Worker and Protection Safety, James Rogers, the New York City Department of Investigation, and our frequent partner, Commissioner Mark Peters. And from my office, we have Assistant DA Meredith McGowan, who is responsible for putting this case into the grand jury, Assistant DA Diane Florence, who is the attorney in charge of our construction task force. She's been doing an amazing job since that task force commenced. And Jody Kane, Chief of the Rackets Bureau, as well as Mike Sachs, who's the Chief of our Investigation Division. Now, according to a recent report, was there a... according to a recent report, the average cost of building in New York City is $354 per square foot. And it surpasses other major cities like London, Zurich, Tokyo, and even Hong Kong as the number one most expensive place to build, with globally recognized opportunities for profits in New York. And nowadays, we all have the same experience. You look up, and everywhere there are buildings going up and coming down, and our famous skyline continues to shapeshift with great breathtaking speed. Some of these buildings are stunning, architecturally masterpieces that all inspire us, others perhaps less so. Either way, we are experiencing a historic building boom, and contractors are eager to strike while the iron is hot. And amid the constant backdrop we see of hazard signs, caution tape, and scaffolding, sometimes it's all too easy to forget that there is a human cost to all this development. Often, it's the very people who are asked to tasked with building this great city who are the most vulnerable to fraud from their managers and their employers. And in some cases, it's only after an irreversible tragedy or massive fraud takes place that these abuses have been exposed. There are two schemes which we are announcing today in indictments filed in court today. The first is a wage theft scheme, and it relates to the reality that construction workers are responsible for some of the most dangerous jobs in the city, whether they're working thousands of feet up in the air or underground. And every day, many of these laborers who risk their lives do so with total uncertainty as to whether they'll be paid fairly and fully for their work. Wage theft, unfortunately, remains one of the most pervasive and insidious issues facing tens of thousands of everyday New Yorkers who lose more than $1 billion of stolen wages each year. It impacts employees all across every industry, but it is especially common in the construction business, where unscrupulous employers are devising new and different ways to cheat and steal from their employees. A case in point, today we are announcing charges against Parkside Construction, its affiliates, four of its senior employees, and its payroll company, Affinity Human Resources, for grand larceny, scheme to defraud, and insurance fraud. As alleged in the indictment, in 2016 and 2017, Parkside held over $100 million in contracts to perform superstructure work on new high-rise buildings in Manhattan, including several well-publicized hotels and condominium towers. To my right, you may not recognize some of these buildings, but 115 West 57th Street, which you may recognize as the super luxury tower in Midtown, or you may recognize the shadow that it casts over Central Park. Parkside's contracts in Manhattan alone, as represented on this poster with these buildings, were worth more than $100 million. And you would think that there would be enough money there to fairly compensate the hundreds of workers they hire to perform concrete installation and masonry projects, which are among the most dangerous in this industry. Instead, Parkside Construction has been charged with systematically altering their workers' timesheets, lowering their weekly wages, and then submitting the falsified timesheets to Affinity Human Resources, an external services and payroll processing firm. These timesheets weren't just a here and there kind of thing, that is the alterations on those timesheets. This was the business model for these defendants. These alterations were purposeful, calculated, and consistent, And by doctoring their employees' timesheets, the defendants were able to steal more than $1.7 million from over 500 workers, workers who are principally immigrants, often undocumented. Now, if workers complained or questioned the missing wages, they were told in substance that there was a mistake and they would be paid the next week. Others were told that if they couldn't, that if they could find other jobs, if they weren't satisfied with the job they had now with these companies. So to be clear, this was not a question of job satisfaction. This was an alleged widespread theft by an employer, Parkside Construction, its payroll services provider, Affinity HR, and their senior staff members, all of whom we allege were complicit in the scheme. And to those who believe that they may have been the victim of a similar scheme, and to undocumented New Yorkers out there who may not feel empowered to stand up against employers who steal, please know this. My office and the offices of my government partners are here to protect your rights, and you can work with us to obtain justice without fear of being deported. Since 2015, my office has maintained an open complaint line, and you can report wage theft and other construction crimes anonymously using WhatsApp, and that number is 646-712-0298. There's a second scheme alleged in these indictments, and it's a workers' compensation insurance fraud scheme. As if stealing from workers wasn't enough, Parkside, with the help of Affinity HR, also concealed more than $40 million in payroll from the New York State insurance fraud as part of a workers' compensation insurance fraud scheme. In New York State, all employers are required to maintain workers' compensation coverage for all their employees. And that's particularly important in the construction industry, which, as I mentioned earlier, involves some of the most dangerous jobs in the city. Parkside Construction and Affinity HR, however, allegedly grossly misrepresented and understated their payroll in order to maintain the workers' compensation coverage needed to obtain lucrative subcontracts on big construction projects at a fraudulently low cost. For instance, Parkside and one of its affiliates reported combined payrolls of just over $4 million, when in fact, their combined payroll was actually more than $29 million. Another Parkside affiliate reported payroll of approximately $3.3 million, when it was actually more than $16.4 million. Altogether, the indictments allege that the defendants failed to report more than $40 million in payroll, for which they owed at least $7.8 million in premiums. And what's particularly interesting about this scheme is the relationship between Parkside and Affinity HR. Affinity is what is technically known as a professional employer organization, or PEO. Now, like many outsourced business service providers, many PEOs are based out of state, and Affinity, for example, is based in Michigan. But no matter where you're based, it's illegal to file false paperwork and misrepresent information about company employees and payroll, particularly when those misrepresentations are made to commit fraud totaling millions of dollars. So today, once again, we are saying to those in the construction industry who take advantage of their employees at the expense of the employee's safety, that you cannot hide the work that you are doing that defrauds your employees. You cannot hide behind out-of-state PEOs and other vendors in order to avoid your responsibility to your workers. Arraignments in today's cases are expected later this afternoon before Judge Caro in Part 32 on the 13th floor of 100 Center Street. I'd like to thank again all the agencies who have been our partners, as well as the dedicated investors, auditors, and assistant TAs who assisted in today's investigation. And in addition to those on stage, I'd also like to acknowledge contributions by the Port Authority of New York and the New Jersey Office of the Inspector General. They have been vital partners to our office over the course of several construction industry successes in many recent years, including a landmark manslaughter conviction in 2016 and the return of $500,000 in stolen wages to Manhattan workers since December 2017 alone. I'd now like to introduce, as I said, one of our great partners in our work, the DOI Commissioner, Mark Peters.
Thank you, District Attorney Vance, and thank you to your team standing here today, including Chief of the Investigation Division, Michael Sachs, Chief of the Rackets Bureau, Jody Kane, Attorney in Charge of Construction Fraud Task Force, Diana Florence, and Assistant District Attorney, Meredith McGowan. The work we have done, DOI has done on the construction fraud task force within the DA's office has been some of the most important work around a really valuable partnership. The work on this case, the results of this investigation, drive home the striking impact that construction fraud has in New York City. In this case, construction fraud stole the hard-earned wages from construction workers, $101.75 million in wages, according to the charges. Parkside Construction and its co-defendants manipulated these workers by teasing them with the promise of a fair wage, and instead, the reality was that paychecks failed to accurately represent all the hours worked or underpaid the overtime rate. The sheer number of workers whose wages were stolen, more than 500, powerfully demonstrates the far-reaching nature of this conduct charge and how many unsuspecting workers it entrapped. One worker, for instance, had nearly $50,000 in wages stolen from him over a 3-year period. Working alongside prosecutors in the Manhattan DA's office, DOI interviewed dozens of workers and executed 4 search warrants. We brought our insight and knowledge about the construction industry and how fraud, including wage theft, can invade these sites. We worked so many of these investigations alongside the Manhattan District Attorney and other members of the Construction Fraud Task Force, a task force born of the recognition that following the rules, keeping construction sites safe, and protecting workers' wages requires a vigorous, coordinated approach. And combining our expertise and knowledge in this area has had some great results, including reaching and connecting with construction workers to ensure that they have the right training. Together, when the Manhattan District Attorney and DOI saw that safety card certifications were being fabricated in prior cases and workers' lives were at risk, we established a program to reach out to these workers through the relevant consulates from countries where many of these workers had originated, including Ecuador and Mexico. I'm pleased to announce that since the beginning of that effort in 2016, we have conducted dozens of safety training presentations and reached more than 2,000 workers, providing them proper training and letting them know that law enforcement in New York City is on their side. This is very clear. These workers' courage help law enforcement advance this investigation and uncover this insidious corruption. I commend them for speaking to us and stepping forward. This investigation is an example of how government, how law enforcement should work, holding those accountable to who seek to exploit the vulnerable and providing justice to victims. I'm proud to stand here with the team of investigators and prosecutors. Before ending, I want to thank the DOI team who worked tirelessly on this investigation to bring justice to these hundreds of workers who failed to get their correct wages. Special Investigator Janina Seguencia, Assistant Inspectors General Dan Taylor and Tiffany Ingraham, Chief Investigator James McGallicutt under the supervision of Inspector General Greg Cho, Associate Commissioner Jay Flaherty, Deputy Commissioner and Chief of Investigation Susan Lambiazzi, and First Deputy Commissioner Leslie Brovner. Thank you.
Thank you, Mark. And now to talk about the insurance fraud aspect of this case.